Good morning again. I got disconnected. I don't know what's happened, but we will start over. Our reading is from the book Living Spring by the spirit author Emmanuel and the medium Francisco Cândido Xavier. And the reading is Go and Teach. Therefore, go and teach. Jesus, Matthew 28:19. As we ponder the Lord's commandment to his disciples, go and teach, we need to remember that Jesus himself came and taught. He came from the heavenly heights and taught the way of spiritual elevation to those who are stuck in earthly darkness. Christ could have given his lesson through faithful emissaries, or he could have spoken brilliantly, explaining how to do it. However, in order to teach surely and fruitfully, he preferred to come to the world of human beings and dwell with them in order to show them how to live on the pathway to perfection. Thus, rather than some other way, he humbled himself and was born in the manger. He honored work and studied in the home, and in public he was the providential brother of all, helping each one according to his needs. It is inarguably correct that Jesus is called the Divine Master, not because he had a throne of gold, not because he was the owner of the best library in the world, not because he merely exalted the correct and irreproachable word, not because he ascended the throne of cultural superiority, dictating obligations to his listeners, but because he lifted up his own heart in fraternal love and teaching, made himself a benefactor to all those who received his sublime lessons. He spoke to us about the Eternal Father, and through his selflessness, he showed us the best way to search for him. So, if you propose to work for the gospel, remember that speaking, advising, and informing are not enough. Go and teach, in the words of Christ, means go and set an example so that others may learn how it should be done. After this wonderful message, invite all to raise our thoughts to our Heavenly Father, to our Master Jesus, so that we can welcome this new day with joy and gratitude. We thank for all the opportunities of learning that we've received so far, and for today, for this present moment, we ask our Master Jesus, our example, our model to be followed. All the examples that he gave us of humbleness, of compassion, so that he can help each one of us to be in touch today, at this present moment, and throughout our day, with the best that we have in us. The best feelings of gratitude, of compassion, of respect, of love, so that we can go and teach with our own example. If you are going through a hardship, let's exercise our faith and go through it in peace. Because if you know, we are doing all we can. Our Father is helping us, giving us the strength, and at the right time, all that we need, it will be provided. So to calm our minds, our hearts, to calm our anxieties, is to exercise our faith in our Creator, in our Master Jesus, the governor of our planet. And even when things in us and around us seem chaotic, it can be only our perception. And also, it's only a question of time. Jesus is the governor of our planet and is continuing to work tirelessly to help us evolve, to help us go into a better situation, into a world of regeneration. So, but it's up to each one of us to also, as we learned on the message, go and teach with our own example. It's how we live every day, every single day, every moment, every second, minute, hour of our day that counts. May we nourish health thoughts, loving thoughts, so that we can also speak in a positive way, in a loving way. And in turn, have the feelings in our actions reflect what we nurture in our thoughts. May God help and strength all of us today and always. So let us now take a moment so we can say our own prayer. We can ask for those, for our loved ones, for those that we know are in so much need. Express our gratitude. So let us now take a moment of silence. Sending a loving thought to all those who just received a diagnostic of our illnesses that will change their lives. To those that are in the hospitals in treatment, many times painful treatments. To those that are in the hospices, being prepared to return to the spiritual world. Those that are in the streets, in the prisons, the physical prisons, but also in the prisons of their own minds. That are disturbed. For all those who are looking, are numbing themselves through all sort of addictions and waste precious time, but also for all those that are working to improve themselves, those that are tirelessly working, many times in silence, without being noticed, without calling much attention, but in their silence of their hearts and their minds, are praying, are cultivating love, and through their daily example of humility and compassion, they are the true workers of goodness, of light, spreading love wherever they go. So for all of us, the billions of incarnates and disincarnates, we ask our Father's blessing once again. Thank you, and let us all have a day where we can express in our thoughts, in our minds, in our hearts, in a smile, the gratitude for being alive and for being here. Thank you, and so be it.